in South Carolina.
So could other North Charleston officers be in legal trouble because of these police reports? I want to bring in criminal defense attorney Brian Claypool. So, Brian, you have two sergeants in their reports. These are sergeants. These are leaders in this police department, and they say that CPR was given to Walter Scott. The video doesn't show all of the aftermath, but it certainly shows minutes after he was shot. Did the officers in their reports break any laws here?
Well, I don't think they broke any laws, and realistically, I don't think they're going to be charged criminally in this case at all. They might, though, face civil liability under the Fourth Amendment for an unlawful seizure. And for the grief and the despair that Mr. Scott went through from the time he was shot until he died. But the problem with prosecuting a police officer criminally for failing to render medical aid is an issue of causation. Because anytime you charge an officer with a crime, you've got to prove causation. For example here, that the failure to render the medical aid actually contributed substantially to Mr. Scott dying, and that would be a daunting task.
I see what you're saying, because he had been shot 5 times.
Correct.
And it was very possible that even if he had gotten aid immediately, he might have passed away. Okay, so what about whether or not this is a slam dunk case? Even though there's this video, you say it's not.
Right.
For murder or perhaps even for manslaughter.
Right. I'm telling you, I know everybody is feeling some degree of relief because Slager has been charged with murder, but I will tell you, look at the track record of police officers nationwide prosecuted for murder. It's not a good one. Getting a conviction against a police officer, even in the face of a videotape like this, is very, very difficult, because at the starting point, the police officer gets a 10-yard head start in a 100-yard dash because their job is to protect the public and the community.
Okay, so let's talk about what might come out in a court of law in this case. You've heard from now Mario Givens, this other resident there, who was tased when he wasn't even the suspect that Slager was looking for. It seemed that Slager may have, and he was exonerated, it seems that Slager may have sort of tased him and then asked questions later. Could that be introduced in a court of law? Might that sway the jury as to what the impulses of Officer Slager, what the pattern of his impulses are?
Right, I think that's a good point. If Slager is tasing somebody who's not even a suspect in a crime, then that likely shows that he has a propensity for doing this, and maybe he's not mentally stable to be on the police force. You also have to look at prior complaints that have been filed by citizens against Slager. Any prior civil lawsuits.
That'll come in?
Oh, yeah, that'll be investigated. That will absolutely be investigated to show that he has a pattern and practice of engaging in a maniacal behavior like this. That'll be an important set of facts to look at.
All right, Brian Claypool, thanks so much for your insight.
Sure, thanks.
And next, a